What's up, everybody? So today I'm going to be going over on what I pack for my travels. And it's honestly not that hard personally, just because of how lazy I am. And I'm going to be showing you on how I do it. So let's get to it. So my first time actually traveling, being on an airplane, was when I was 18. And here's a photo of myself taking a selfie in a Southwest airline flight to UC Davis. That was when my school actually invited us from Southern California to check out the school for the weekend. I thought it was pretty cool. I thought the airplane was like a roller coaster ride. And since then, I was just yearning for traveling, you know? Over the past 5 years, it's safe to say that I've been traveling worldwide or even across the US through either internship programs, study abroad, or just plain old leisure. And I'm gonna show you what I take, and it's honestly not that much. Considering that I'm pretty lazy, just because I will literally pack the morning of if my flight is that evening. So this is actually a photo of my room the day I was leaving from Russia to come back into the US when my program was ending. And as you can see, there are three bags that I took for the entire 8 weeks, which is honestly, it's crazy for me to think that I only had three pieces of luggage and I made it work for those 8 weeks. Considering what I've learned there and what I have now, like, there's no way I'd be able to do all that. And my luggage is slightly bigger just because of the camera equipment that I take now and the other hobbies that I like to do when I'm on vacation, such as diving. So compared to the luggage I had when I studied abroad in Russia, this is a photo of myself at the airport that my mom took of me as she dropped me off. I was on my way to Washington DC as I had an internship there. It was called the UCDC program. I have a video of it, link in the description below. But that's the luggage that I took, and I was there for about like 10 weeks if I remember correctly. So as you can see, my bags are a bit stuffed. I took a lot of things there, and I'm actually proud of the bags that I had because they held so much. So these are one of the two luggages that I use and check in. And I hold these for clothing for the most part. There's so much space in it. Literally, I'm so lazy. Like, honestly, when I pack, I just throw in all my clothes in there and there if needed, just because it just makes life so much easier and I don't like to waste time with packing and such. That's why I use them. So for both of these, I bought them at Ross. I think they were like 40 bucks, 50 bucks total for both of them, which is a steal given the amount of size and space they hold. Because, you know, let's be honest, luggage is so much expensive. So it's good to go cheap, but it's good quality just because it's lasted me for the past 2 years or so. And once it rips completely, I'm gonna go back to Ross and buy another set again. This is my travel pillow. Usually have it on me. I got it on Amazon, I think for about 20 bucks. It's a little ripped right here, but it still does its job. There's not much more to say. It keeps me comfortable for those long flights. All right, let's move on to travel backpacks that I use. This is a Tarion PB01. I got it for about 120 bucks in January 2021. Now I think they're running about 140 inflation, but it's pretty good. Very spacious. It could hold a camera and then more stuff that you need. I would recommend it, no, honestly. This is a video of me in Paris. I was at a convention center. I saw that video. I didn't realize until then that it's a pretty big bulky backpack. If you're short like me, it's gonna look pretty bulky on you. But also, I figured over the years, I knew that it's kind of overkill just because it holds so much space and then some. So I don't use this as much anymore just because I bought a new backpack. And let's be honest, it looks wise, it's not that great. It just looks very big and bulky. So for me, looks kind of matter, you know. I don't want something flashy like Gucci, but I also want something that just looks good and is a little bit smaller. Which brings me to my next backpack. My most expensive, and honestly, it's probably the last one that I'm ever gonna buy just because of how expensive it was. My Shimoda V30, I believe that's what it's called. It's about 400 bucks. I believe they're running about 385 on Amazon. You know, after taxes, over 400 bucks, which is insane. And the reason why I bought that is because, you know, I looked at the reviews, everybody was recommending it, and it's like the only bag you need for the rest of your life, which I plan to use for the rest of my life. I really don't want to buy another bag after this one. I've used it. Unfortunately, I haven't been able to use it for international travel. I just only use it for domestic, and it's very good. It does its job. The layout is different, you know, compared to a traditional backpack. So to open this bag, it's weird. You have to turn it upside down, and there's zippers right here. It's hard for me to show you, but let's just open it up. It's easier on the ground, obviously. But yeah,
this is very different compared to your traditional backpack. The camera goes in here, whatever you want in here. And it's smaller, obviously. You could hold your laptop in here, but it has to be a smaller one. So I just hold my big laptop in this pocket right here. For 400 bucks, you know, the quality is pretty good so far. I plan to use it more often. Unfortunately, I'm not able to travel as often as I used to. But yeah, I like it. It looks good. I like the color. Right here, you can put your phone. Open this pouch for a water bottle. You know, obviously, to some people, it's not worth it. You know, 400 bucks is a lot, especially for a travel bag, and I get that. But to me, you know, I have the money. I figured, you know, why not? Let's try it. It's up to you if you want to buy, you know, $120 or $140 backpack or $400 one. And this one's obviously bigger and just as sturdy as well. And also, before I forget, what I have on my carry-on as well is my passport. This is a passport cover I bought off Amazon. I think like 10 bucks. Some people may disagree. Some don't like having passport book covers just because it's so annoying just having to take the passport out, TSA. But personally, I don't mind. What I carry in it is obviously passport itself, my vaccine cards, original and laminated copies. Countries don't even ask for them anymore. They did back in 2021, so it was easier to have it on me now, you know, just in case. Also, you can have like credit card pockets, whatever you need in there, or other identification. But that's what I have my wallet for. I wouldn't trust this completely just to hold my, you know, that type of information. But I really like it. You know, it's easy to have. The only issue I have is that it's a little bit bulky. So when you have jeans, it's hard to put in your pocket. But that's why I like to wear sweats in the airport, just because it's easier to carry it inside my pocket. But that's the only issue, really. So I'd recommend it. The barbers here suck. They messed up my lineup. I know in the comments, don't roast me, please. I know it looks bad. Aside from that, though, this is my toiletry bag. I would recommend it. Bought it off Amazon, too. I think like 15 bucks or 20, I don't know. It is a Lubardi. That's the brand, Lubardi type. It's actually pretty good. It holds a lot, like compared to its size. Like there's a lot of space in here just for whatever you need, shampoo, conditioner, like the small ones, of course, the travel ones. You know, whatever toiletry you need, this bag will hold a lot and then some. And then it has pockets right here as well on the sides. So I would recommend it. I use it every single time I travel.
So lastly, I decided to talk about my scuba dive luggage, just because not everybody dives. And if you don't worry, that's the end of the video, you can leave now. But this is my Pelican Air hard case bag that I carry my dive equipment. Figured if you're gonna hold, you know, hundreds of dollars worth of dive equipment, you wanna put it in someplace sturdy, and this one holds it just fine. It's a 1626, I think it was about 300 bucks. On Amazon, but I think it's worth it just because it holds all my equipment. It even holds my wetsuit, actually. I don't want to stuff it in, but you can just fold it easily. And then right here, you can hold the two locks. You know, very sturdy, worth it. I took it to me in Acapulco, Mexico. Gotta put stickers on it. This does fit. I tried it. I'm kind of lazy right now. I don't want to put it in.
So, quick funny story regarding my hard case luggage. We were at LAX. My mom and I, we were about to miss our flight, and then the guy at the front desk of Aeromexico said, "I got it. Don't worry about it. So just go to our flight." So we went. Somehow he managed to put a different name other than my own. I don't know how, but shit happens. So then once I got to my final destination at Acapulco, my luggage is nowhere to be found, so I'm already filing a claim and I'm like worried about it. But then once I'm back in Mexico City, I figured, you know, might as well check lost and found. So I go to lost and found for the luggage. I show them a photo of it and I describe the components, and I also tell them I had two locks in it. And thankfully I was able to unlock it, and obviously just to prove that it's my luggage that they had. So the reason why I tell you that story is because if I had not like had the locks on it, if I had not been able to show them the photo of it, or you know, describe it to them, I probably would not have gotten it back. So it's always good to just have distinct luggage that you know that it's yours for sure, because a lot of luggage looks the same as well. And then, you know, put your name tag aside from the actual name tag that you're supposed to put on when you check your bag in. And then just use something that allows you to describe it just in case you lose it. And also, I have travel insurance with my Amex Platinum card. So Amex would have covered it. Well, I like to think they would have, but you know, insurance claims can be sometimes. So as you can see, that's pretty much it, how I pack for my travels. There's not much to it. I like to pack smarter, not harder. Let me know what your thoughts are in the comments below, or if there's any advice you can give me, because I'm always looking to improve how I pack for my travels. And lastly, my next video will be about why I got into diving, how I got into diving, because I feel like I owe it to y'all to know the process, how I got into it, and how y'all can get into it as well. I love diving. That's why I like to go places where I can also dive. And that's pretty much it. See y'all next time. Peace out.